Hello everyone, welcome to setting up Crystal Audio Engine for ASIO. This is actually the second part of a video. As you may remember, if you've seen the first one, I went through setting up the Windows audio preferences so as to allow use of audio in the Crystal Audio Engine. Tonight we'll actually go through the ASIO side of things, setting that up to suit Crystal Audio. So for those that don't already know, ASIO is a low latency audio input that Windows can use to negate the effect of its own downfall, so to speak. As you're probably aware, Windows has got horrible latency issues when it comes to audio, so ASIO was invented basically to overcome that. Crystal Audio Engine is ASIO compatible, and it's quite worth the hassle, and I say hassle because it is a little bit temperamental to set up and get running. I'd say the number one problem most people have with KAE initially is the latency factor and getting the ASIO working. So I thought I'd make a video that might help. One thing I should mention is that before you start trying to use the ASIO side of things in Crystal, you will need to have either ASIO for all or the appropriate ASIO driver for your sound card. Sometimes they come with them. The M-Audio does. It's a very good one. The other option is KX Project drivers. They're very good. Combo Bob swears by them. But they must be installed and set up to get the actual hardware operating before you can use it within KAE. Okay, roll the footage. So if you look down the left-hand side on the screen there, you'll see the audio output in the waiver in KAE. That lists all the available output devices, i.e. sound card outputs, that's available to the system while recording or playing back. You can see the ASIO for all and M-Audio, the two I use up top for ASIO, but there's also the MMEs. MME or Windows Audio is quite a viable option, but latency does tend to be a big issue. It can be overcome by simply dragging your files slightly to the left of screen after you've recorded them to bring them back into sync. It's a bit fiddly, but it works. These devices can also be found in the list. If you go up to the engine, drop that down, go preferences, you'll get this dialog box that you can actually see on screen there to device information. That's got all the outputs listed. Also the VSTs list in that, which is quite handy sometimes if you want to investigate the internals of the VST. It does give you a little bit of information about them. Okay, so we'll close that screen, go back up into the engine menu, go to preferences. That brings up this dialog box there. You can see all the different options. You've got the general audio setups, VST devices. General can be good. You can actually set an external editor by clicking there, and it's just a matter of finding the program, locating it, and telling Crystal where to find it. You can also go down to audio setup. Now you'll notice there it says no output. That's because I haven't got the ASIO running at the moment. Basically what we're going to do is set this up now. Just quickly, you can also have a look at the devices. That lists, this is where you actually set the devices that will display in the audio output dialog bit of the mixer window. As you can see, all sorts of different little outputs going on there at the moment. The three at the top are native to Crystal, I think. I don't really know what they're for. I disable them. I don't need them. This is the ASIO side, the top one that I'm actually selecting there now. I leave ASIOs for all and the M-Audio ASIO selected. So that tells Crystal that I want both them outputs available as ASIO outputs. Same applies for the MME, playback and record. It's only a matter of selecting the devices that you want or don't want. Okay, so word of warning, this is only my way of doing it, so if you do it at your own risk. The usual disclaimer applies. Now, I've made changes to the preferences. A very important thing in Crystal to do is actually quit the program after you do make changes within the preferences, otherwise they don't take effect in the program. So I'll restart KAE. Just wait a second while it boots up. Okay, now that you've made the changes to the preferences, if you go down to the audio outputs and click there, it should now reflect the changes that you've made, i.e. the available inputs. As you can see, I haven't actually done anything to the devices as such. I just disabled those three ASIO drivers, so now we'll go back in and play with the settings a little. So the first thing to do is select ASIO 1 or M-Audio, the appropriate driver in the output audio output part of the waiver. Go back into preferences and you'll see it displayed under the audio setup tab. Now instead of saying no output, it actually gives the details of the available inputs and outputs of the ASIO. So you'll see the two boxes. You've got ASIO inputs. You can select them by either clicking on the tick or de-clicking the tick. There's also the ASIO outputs. My Audigy actually has the surround sound, so it's multiple outputs. But for my use, I do select all but the first two, the SB Live 1 and 2s. Now, after any changes within this preferences box, don't forget to click apply. Same principle as with Windows. If you go to the audio setup, now you can actually set your sample rate. I have it set to the standard 44.1 most of the time. Sometimes I use the 48, and I even had to go at 96 recently, but you can just change that there by going up and down. There's also a preload amount, which is like buffering. 2 seconds is a standard, and I leave it set at that. You can also see up the top it says block size. That's the equivalent of your buffers that you set within the ASIO, and it says that it's 32-bit lead side bus resolution. So now if you select the switch there, it says ASIO control panel. That'll bring up ASIO for all's control panel. Just check that all your WMD list, the green means that they're running or selected. That's, as you can see, the audio G is running there at the moment. The audio file isn't. I don't use ASIO for all for the audio file. It doesn't tend to get on very well with it. You can go over and change your samples in the latency compensation. I'm not really sure with these things. They say you should just experiment to get them done. There's also the AC troubleshooting, the always resample 44 to 48. It's got something to do with creative cards and the force WMD driver to 16-bit, which pretty well states what it does. I leave everything over that side unselected. Now, if you look down the bottom there, you'll see ASIO running. That tells you that it's running at 44.1. So if you actually look over to where it says ASIO buffer sizes, mine's set at 640 there at the moment, you can tell whether you're overloading or the actual ASIO is running right by moving that to the left down to a point where, as you'll see in a moment, I'll do this and it'll come up as overload down where I just had the mouse cursor then. So I'll slide it down. See how it's now flashing overload. That is when you'll get pops and clicks, means that your buffer underrunning, as in you haven't got enough buffers set. So if you slide it gradually up until it disappears. Notice it's got quicker there, I'm getting close. Keep going a little bit further, I'm at 280, take it up to 416, and it seems to work at 416. So if we take it back down to where it actually starts to flash overload again, that would be the minimum buffer settings that your card is capable of. So I'd take it up one or two clicks past that as a minimum. My setup, I usually use 512, it seems to work fine. That pretty well wraps up the ASIO for all setup. Just before you go, make sure all your inputs are green that you're using. They can be available and not running. If there's any little red crosses there, there's a problem. Okay, so now I'm going to disable the MME inputs. I don't use them, as I said before, some people do. So if you go down to the audio output in the mixer, you'll see they're all available there, as well as the two ASIO inputs. So the way to do that is to go up and select the preferences again. Down there, and once you've got that up, go down to the devices down there, open that up, see the MME playback list. I deselect all of them, both in the record and the playback for the MME. So if you select OK when you've done that, close that window. If you go back and check the mixer console audio output again, you'll notice that the MMEs are still there, even though I've deselected them. So this is where we need to shut down Crystal Audio. It basically refreshes the program and reinstates the preferences as you've set them. So we'll close it down and reboot it, of course. And now if we go back and check the mixer's audio output, you'll notice the only two available inputs are the ASIO because I've deselected the others. You can also just quickly duck back up into the preferences menu just to make sure that they're all deselected. Go to devices again and make sure they're all deselected, which they are. There we go. Okay, we're all done. So we'll close that window. So you can also swap devices at any given time. I'll change it over to the M-Audio there now. It reflects that through saying ASIO 2 there. If we go up into the preferences now, you have control of the M-Audio settings. As you can see, it's changed from the ASIO for all to the M-Audio there. Once again, ASIO control panel's available. That's the M-Audio one there, which I won't go into because it's beyond the scope of this. Just be aware that you can change the inputs at any given time. Okay, so that's about it. I hope this has helped someone in some small way, because as I said, it can be quite difficult to set up the ASIO and get it running within Crystal. So, anyway, thank you for watching. It's been Levi Nye from KE Forums. Enjoy making music, folks. Just die.